Social and Family Development Minister Desmond Lee has just met a group of food delivery riders affected by the recent e-scooter ban from footpaths. Now, they gathered at his Meet the People session in Jurong this evening, where Mr. Lee said that he would convey their concerns to the Transport Ministry. Gwyneth Cho and Melissa Goh with more.
Based on CNA's observations, some 60 delivery riders were present, dressed in uniforms of various food delivery companies. They gathered more than an hour before the Meet the People session was supposed to begin. Speaking to them, MP Desmond Lee, who is also Social and Family Development Minister, said grassroots volunteers and union staff were on hand to address any immediate issues the riders were facing.
They have genuine concerns about livelihood, about income, and of course all the related issues. So I not only met the PMD riders, I also met someone representing the industry from the shops that sell PMDs. So they came up with some suggestions. I'm from MSF. We will want to make sure that if they have urgent concerns from what has happened to their livelihoods, we will be in a position to assist them as quickly as we can. If they like to meet me one-on-one, I'll be in my office. And they were constructive in coming up with various possibilities. These are issues that my colleagues at the Ministry of Transport and LTA would have to consider, and so I think I would leave it to them to assess them carefully and to reply to them.
In response to CNA's queries, food delivery company Foodpanda said it's working with the Land Transport Authority and other partners to help e-scooter riders switch to other modes of transport at affordable rates. These rates will also apply to all delivery companies. Speaking to CNA, transport analyst Walter Tessera suggested authorities should help delivery companies place riders in other jobs or switch from e-scooters to power-assisted bicycles or motorcycles. This in order to help minimize disruption to their livelihoods.
Get a list of your drivers, try and find out what information you know about them, for example, their qualifications, you know, age, things like that, and to try and figure out what would be realistic jobs or pathways that you can put them in. In terms of our vocational training pathways, whether there's some skills gaps or training we can provide to them and then help them transition. And I think in all of this, we have to bear in mind that because their livelihood has been cut off suddenly, we may have to see whether we can give them the necessary financial support, you know, not just training but also for their families.
According to official data, some 7,000 delivery riders are affected by the ban of e-scooters from footpaths that came into effect on Monday. When the government first announced this, it said it would work with such companies to help riders switch to other modes of transport.